people, welcome back to Politricks Watch. This is Sir P. Now I'm gonna talk mostly about Livity Coke today and a certain nickname that he has. And this nickname, to be honest, is not a street name because as far as I'm aware, nobody in the streets na call him this. And to be honest, I wouldn't advise anybody to call him this, right? Now you'd have heard, of course, Livity. You'd have heard Live Up, right? But for some members of the JDF, especially the man them who they were in, they served over Security Post 11, about 2011 or 2012, them time there, they have a different name for Livity. And now in case you're wondering what is Security Post 11 or where is it, then I have a video on it on my channel, you can go check it out, right? It's basically a section over Horizon that was run exclusively by the JDF. You have like the main prison, we have the ward of them, and them deal with the majority of the prisoners them, but you have some prisoners who had to be moved over to the Security Post to get special attention. These prisoners, right, were normally high profile, you know, them have whole heap of ratings on the street, them not take no talk, them not listen to nobody. You have to understand, them time there, it was normal for man used to fight with water, right? Man a fight off water, then them pick up this style where them used to do a number one in a buckle and then just chew it upon all the stuff. Matter of fact, let me show you this video. Look at your screen right now. That was a video released by the Correctional Services showing, I mean, by the JDF, right? Outside a youth cell, and the youth dash some urine in him face. Can you imagine that? Can you imagine that jail? Right, a man I go pee pee in a cup and dash upon you. Man used to do number two in a bucket, the number two. Some of the man literally do number two in them hand and fling it upon soldiers. Right. So we're talking about a time when things was very, very acidic in the prison, right? Man them not did not talk. The prisoner them rough, the soldier them rough, everybody have it out for each other. Right. You can go on the Jamaica Observer YouTube page, right, and you can search in unruly prisoners and you see the rest of that video when you don't watch this one, right? But understand, we have to try to set the context as to how things used to run. Man I get number one, man I get urine dashing at them face, number two I get dash on them, right? Unspeakable things. So and as I said, anybody can imagine what that would be like. So enough of the man them, right, who not do that decide to them not in attack, right? Them a bad man, them run after, so let me drip up water, drip up soldier, fight soldier. It sounds incredible, but a damn thing they like one, because at the time there was an attempt to, I guess, you know, be diplomatic with the prisoners until that stopped. And one of the man they made stop on, one of the man they end up learning the hard way was Livity Coke. Livity Coke going to prison and him going there, I tell the man them about Obama, right? Which was typical for the man them from one of West Kingston, right? Them love talk about Obama. As a matter of fact, the same Livity actually have a brother that I mentioned in the P-Boy video whose name was Bama T, right? Real name Lanchester Coke, right? So them love the whole Bama thing, right? And Livity go in there a brag and I talk about Bama. Every day when he first job at prison, every day I talk about West Kingston him come from and boss Bama and be a Bama talk. And for those of you who don't know, Bama is street name for a rifle, right? Now I've heard different communities give different rifles the name Bama, but me know originally the first type of rifle me hear man called Bama was of course the infamous L1A1 self-loading rifle, aka the SLR, right, which JDF used to use, one of the most horrific rifles ever invented, right, the bone broker and skull crusher, right. You know, enough man used to call it the Bama, right. So Livity Coke going to jail that talk about Bama this and Bama that. Drop over Security Post 11, right? Fight off soldier and not take no talk, right? Tell him my name, so if you diss him and you come back on road, wait till him catch you. I saw Livity go on because at the time he felt on top of the world. And at the time, you could have just keep up certain little foolishness and not come out of it because there was cameras all over the place and they felt safe. Until one day, an incident went down, as you can see on your screen. That was the end result for Livity. Now I understand that some of you want to take a break right now, right? Go get your tissues and your napkin and, you know, your eyes are flooded with tears for poor little Livity, right? But the incident got on, and according to Livity's doctor, the only reason why him survived is because him played dead. But the JDF disputed and said actually, after the big fight go on, because they say it was a fight, Livity and the man them a fight. After it done, they were the same ones who carried Livity to the medical section for him get looked on. Now, obviously, I wasn't there. But let me tell you this. You can't lay down and play dead in front of a JDF soldier for them bite. This is not the movies, right? You know, I go just drop on the ground and stop move, and a group of JDF soldiers stand up over here and go, oh, look, yeah, he's not moving, dead now. That's not really how it works. Yeah, but that was Liberty's side of the story. Now, people, according to Liberty, the reason why it happened to him is because the PNP ordered it. Listen, these are his exact words. Look at your screen. According to Liberty, and it's underlined in red, before the men started to beat him, they said they received orders to take him out because the People's National Party was now in power. Listen, just picture it. A group of JDF soldiers go over to Liberty with the intention, say they're going to beat him and kill him in a prison. But before them start, them say, hold on, Mr. Liberty Cook, we're just going to inform you that we've received orders from the People's National Party, say we should kill you because they are now in power. That's very unlikely, right? I'm not saying it's totally impossible, but just picture it. When I come over here, come brief you on the reason why they're going to kill you and tell you who sent them. Okay, sure. I mean, and the next thing is, when this narrative was being pushed, because obviously Liberty is affiliated with JLP, West Kingston, here's the problem with that argument. The man them who get the roughest treatment over Security Post 11 during that time were also PNP. So the political narrative doesn't make sense. And again, remember at this point, Liberty is trying to play the card of, oh, I'm just minding my business and me never did nobody nothing and the soldier them just bust up my head, right? Now, at the time, as me say, the man who got the rough treatment down there was none other than Joel Andem, who is affiliated with the PNP, right? Of course, Christopher Linton, Dark Paw, he had a very, very rough time in there, right? My name gave him a very rough treatment as well. Dark Paw was also PNP, right? Richie Poo was PNP. Tesha Miller, my name gave Tesha Miller rough over there, if you understand, right? Tesha Miller was also PNP. These are Tesha Miller's own words after him left jail, right? It's on your screen in underline in red. Prison is a dreadful place. I was even tortured in prison, and I would not want my worst enemy to end up there. That's what Tesha Miller said after him left Security Post 11. You have to understand, people, the post is undefeated. Every man they go over there, if you get attitude adjustment, come back a complete different man, right? A matter of fact, it was not for the pressure with Tesha Miller commander over there or make him decide to say him no want this damn thing no more, right? Because remember, you know, people, Tesha actually hand over the black man while the two of them in a jail. Yeah, black man was also behind bars, right? But Tesha was like, listen, this damn thing, I don't want it no more. And as soon as him come out of jail, he jump on a plane. But of course, we know Tesha end up, right? He end up sending him right back to Jamaica, and now him behind the same bars, he will try to run from, right? But want people to understand something. How did Liberty end up get that nickname? Speci. See, it got to a point where Liberty was now competing with Joel and them and Dark Paw as to who can put on the most balling. And Liberty was winning. Liberty got to the point where as soon as him see the soldier them, the man start ball and roll and behave like a picnic. Nobody couldn't believe it. This was the feared Liberty Cook. This was Live Up who I tell them not so long ago, so make them family in the streets get dashed around it and diss him and it, that are gonna happen to this and that are gonna happen to that. Liberty threw himself on the ground, be a balling. Balling like a little picnic. Because of the balling. And remember, I said him that talk about Bama. That's when the man in my Security Post 11 said, listen, this Bama thing when you're coming, get rid of it. Can't talk about no Bama. Your new name? Speci, as in 0.38 special. Now, for those of you who are not as knowledgeable on weapons, let me just explain that to you. The SLR, the bomber, fires around, which is 7.62 by 51. NATO, a heavy, heavy round, right? If you get hit with that, on almost any part of your body, start plan the funeral arrangements. However, the .38 special, even though it's still a bullet, is a much smaller round. So they were saying, you can't be no bomber, you can't talk about no bomber. You need to talk about special, because you've been downgraded purely based on the way Livity did a ball and a guan. Right? So when I hear the name Speci, and it might be an old time JDF soldier, understand where it's coming from. Now, as I said at the start of the video, if Livity bust the P boy case, I wanna see him down at West Kingston, I wanna see him a walk or somewhere, don't walk up to him and call him no Speci, because you might get 3 rounds out of the Speci. Even though the Speci is a small round, the 3-8 Speci, it can still send him a duff cut, right? They were just downgrading him. Yes, you're a bullet. Yes, you're a round. Yes, you're dangerous. But not no 7.62x51. You're a .38 special. Now, the reason I'm talking about this now is because I didn't want to mention it in the P-Boy kerosene oil store, because that's where I was first going to talk about it. But I might think to myself, you know what? That would overshadow the whole kerosene concept, and I wanted people to focus on the kerosene oil, right, and the P-Boy story, right? So I decided to make the whole special thing a complete separate video. So there you have it, people. Livity Coke, aka Livup, aka Speci, one of the biggest crybabies Horizon has ever seen. But remember, you don't call him that, don't see him nowhere. If he busts the case, P-Boy, don't see him nowhere and call him no Speci. Unless, of course, you have your owner Speci, and you're one of them old-time cowboy types, so like the draw, you know, old-time Western show in time, two-man standoff, and then who draw first, end up win. Unless you come from that school and you like them thing there, no bother with it. But if you notice, you don't really hear these stories coming out of Horizon anymore. So either they have it under control now, right, and there's a drastic change down there, or things are going, but it just now come out on the outside, right? I mean, extreme cases like this, right? And I know stories like this always split the population. Some people, right, I go say, listen, anything people like Livity get deserve, anything people like Tisha get him deserve, while the others whose heart ever bleed for Tisha, and I'm gonna say, all him for deal with Tisha like that, I don't care if he's a done of clansman, you know, he still has certain human rights and he should be treated with respect and dignity. Right, so I'm gonna ever split the population, and the correctional services will remind people that the inmates actually did try to bring some kind of court action and did try to push for charges, but then after investigation, they weren't successful. A matter of fact, one of the things they really help them for not have to suffer any kind of legal repercussions is because they used to always have a cameraman, right? There were cameras in the facilities already, but they used to have a cameraman who used to always, anytime an incident go down, they used to run go start video it right away, right? And then afterwards, them show the video and say, see it, and that person has started first. Well, Livity himself will tell you that in his case, the incident when get him head bust up, it happened in a location that was out of the camera spot. It was in a blind spot, right? And Livity will tell you, listen, if you think I just so happen to get into a fight with the JDF soldiers over Security Post 11 in the blind spot, right, at that precise moment, then Livity will then try and sell you some unicorns, right? So people, there you have it. Patreon squad, big up on yourself. PIA, you don't know, more life. Bless.